Trigonometric integrals, level 2. In the previous video, we started solving trigonometric integrals of the form sine of x raised to the power of m times cosine of x raised to the power of n, where both m and n are positive integers. Recall that we covered the case when the power of cosine was odd. In this video, we will go over an additional case. Let's go over the case when the power of sine is odd. Like in the previous video, let's start with a couple of examples to illustrate the various steps that are key in solving these types of trigonometric integrals. Find the integral of cosine squared of x times sine of x dx. Like in the previous video, always check to see if U-substitution is a viable option before attempting other integration techniques, since U-substitution tends to be the easiest technique to execute. Scanning the integrand, we see that we can actually let u equal cosine of x. Making this substitution and taking the derivative of u with respect to x, we obtain negative sine of x. Then we go ahead and solve for sine of x dx. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, let's go ahead and carry on the substitutions. Doing that, we obtain the following integral in terms of the variable u. Next, let's go ahead and factor out the negative sine and proceed with the integration step. We find the integral by applying the power rule for integration. The integral of u squared is equal to 1/3 times u cubed, and we add the constant c. The final step is to substitute the variable u with the original expression. In this case, the original expression was cosine of x. Doing that, we obtain the following. And finally, we go ahead and simplify the expression, obtaining negative 1/3 times cosine cubed plus c. Notice that in this integral, we had an expression where the power of cosine was even and the power of sine was odd. The reason why the substitution step worked in this integral is because we had a single sine factor that was vital for the substitution step to work. Make sure you place close attention to this little detail in the preceding examples. All right, let's go ahead and try the next example. Find the integral of sine cubed of 5x dx. All right, notice that we have a sine function raised to the power of 3, an odd integer. Like in the previous example, let's try to use u substitution first. But before we can actually carry on a substitution, we need to isolate a single sine of 5x factor so that the u substitution step can work out. So let's go ahead and rewrite the integrand by breaking it apart into a factor raised to the power of 2 and a factor raised to the power of 1, as follows. The reason why we want to break apart an odd power function into an even power factor and a single factor is so that we can rewrite the even power sine function into an expression in terms of cosine. We accomplish this by using the Pythagorean identity, sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1. Notice that as long as both functions, sine and cosine, contain the same expression inside the argument of the function, this relation will hold. So we can actually use this version of the Pythagorean identity to accommodate the problem at hand. Remember, as long as both sine and cosine have the same expression inside the argument, this identity will hold. Using this version of the Pythagorean identity and solving for sine squared of 5x, we obtain 1 minus cosine squared of 5x. Using this expression, we go ahead and replace sine squared of 5x as follows. Now that we have a single sine factor and the rest of the integrand in terms of cosine, let's go ahead and carry on the u substitution step. So we let u equal cosine of 5x, and we also find the derivative of u with respect to x. Make sure you apply the chain rule for this one. Doing that, we have the following. Next, let's go ahead and solve for sine of x. After that, we go ahead and apply the substitutions throughout. Doing that, we have the following expression. Next, let's go ahead and factor out the constant negative 1/5, followed by taking the integral of the expression. The integral of 1 is equal to u, and the integral of u squared is equal to 1/3 times u cubed. Then we add the constant c. Next, let's go ahead and simplify the expression by distributing the constant negative 1/5. The final step is to substitute the variables u with the original function, in this case with cosine of 5x. Doing that, we obtain the final answer equal to negative 1/5 times cosine of 5x plus 1 over 15 times cosine cube of 5x plus c. Notice that in this example, the power on sine was odd, and we proceeded by breaking it apart into a factor with an even power and a factor with a power of 1. Alright, let's try a slightly more challenging example. Find the integral of cosine raised to the power of 4 times sine cube dx. Alright, similar to the last example, notice that we have powers of sine and cosine. The power on cosine is even, and the power on sine is odd. Recall that we want to break apart the odd power into an even power and a single power function, as follows. Having broken apart the odd powered sine function, we go ahead and replace sine squared with an equivalent expression in terms of cosine. So we go ahead and use the Pythagorean identity, sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1, and solve for sine squared as follows. Then we go ahead and replace sine squared with 1 minus cosine squared. Now that we have a single sine factor, and the rest of the integrand is expressed in terms of cosine, we go ahead and carry on the substitution step. So we let u equal cosine of x. Then we find the derivative of u with respect to x. Next, we go ahead and solve for sine of x dx, since this expression occurs in the original integral. Then it's just a matter of substituting these expressions throughout. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Factoring out the negative and distributing u to the power of 4, we obtain the following expression. Now it's just a matter of finding the integral by using the power rule for integration. The integral of u to the power of 4 is just equal to 1/5 times u to the power of 5. And the integral of u to the power of 6 is equal to 1/7 times u to the power of 7. Like always, we include the constant c. Next, we go ahead and distribute the negative sign. Doing that, we obtain the following. The final step is to substitute back the original function for u. In this case, u was equal to cosine of x. Doing that, we obtain the final answer equal to negative 1/5 times cosine raised to the power of 5 plus 1/7 times cosine raised to the power of 7 plus c. Notice that in this example, the power on cosine was even and positive. In addition, the power of sine was odd and positive. In general, we try to write an integrand involving powers of cosine that are even and powers of sine that are odd in a form where we only have one sine factor, and the remainder of the integrand in terms of cosine. With the help of the Pythagorean identity, sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1, we can convert back and forth between even powers of sine and cosine. For this case, we want to use sine squared equals 1 minus cosine squared. This way, we can rewrite even powers of sine into even powers of cosine. After that, we let u equal cosine of x, and carry on with the u-substitution step. And finally, we solve the integral by first expanding the expression if needed, and applying the power rule for integration. This is the second of four cases that we will continue to cover throughout this video series. The one described here is when the power on cosine is even and the power of sine is odd. Alright, let's end the video by going over the final example. Find the integral of cosine squared times sine raised to the power of 5 dx. Notice that we have a product involving powers of sine and cosine. So we need to identify which function contains an odd power, since this is what determines how we solve this integral. In this case, sine of x is raised to the power of 5, an odd number. So let's go ahead and break apart this function into an even power function and a single factor of sine. Doing that, we have the following. The next step is to rewrite sine raised to the power of 4 as sine squared raised to the power of 2. This way, we can substitute the sine squared term with the Pythagorean identity, 1 minus cosine squared, as follows. Now that we have a single sine factor and the rest of the integrand written in terms of cosine, we go ahead and proceed with the u-substitution step. So we let u equal cosine of x. Then we take the derivative of u with respect to x. Then we solve for sine of x dx. After that, we go ahead and substitute these expressions throughout. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, let's go ahead and factor out the negative sign and expand the binomial. Doing that, we obtain the following integral. having expanded the binomial, we go ahead and distribute u squared. Next, we go ahead and find the integral of each term by using the power rule for integration. Taking the integral of each term yields the following expression. Don't forget to add the constant term when you're done taking the integral. Next, let's go ahead and distribute the negative sign. The final step is to substitute back the original function for u. So, we replace the variable u with cosine of x. Doing that, we obtain the final answer equal to negative 1/3 times cosine cubed plus 2/5 times cosine raised to the power of 5 minus 1/7 times cosine raised to the power of 7 plus c. Alright, in our next video on trigonometric integrals, we will go over the third case when the power on sine and cosine are odd.